Okay, good morning. Listen, today's class, it's very essential. If you are going to ask me why, for the following reason. First, today we are going to provide you with something called infrastructure for the sales management course. Therefore, we are going to talk about something called business strategy. In addition, we are going to talk about marketing strategy. Both of them, they will be included in the midterm exam. Both of them, they will be included in the midterm exam. So the title of today's chapter, or chapter number two, Strategy and Sales Program Planning. This is our own title. Now, let's talk about the objectives or the learning objectives, which hopefully we will cover by the end of this chapter. Number one, we are going to describe the major elements of business strategy. And before describing the major elements, today we are going to define what is the meaning of business strategy and why it is important and how or what are the elements which are composing it. Also, we are going to talk about the basic elements of marketing planning. Well, generally, and all the time remember, the word business strategy and marketing strategy, both of the definitions or concepts, they are interrelated. So we cannot talk about something called business strategy without talking about something called marketing strategy. Okay? And today, inshallah, we are going to talk about each component in a very detailed way. In addition, we will try to explain what is meant by a strategic implementation process decision. Well, implementation also, it is something basic. As we are talking about strategies and the planning all the time. Remember, these strategies, they are theories. They are theoretical work. They can be written on papers. But is this enough? Of course not. So what do we need? We need to execute these strategies. Through what? Implementation strategies. In the third or in the fourth, we are going to describe the purpose of a Salesforce program and its major elements. Or finally, we will conclude by what is an account relationship strategy and explain its own purposes. So these are briefly the major learning objectives which we will cover on. Type. Let's talk about the outline of our chapter. How it is built, how it is drawn. The outline of our chapter, by focusing on business strategy and marketing strategy. Then we will talk about factors influencing strategic management. Thirdly, we are going to talk about business strategies. Fourth, we are going to talk about go-to-market strategy. And then product development management, or BDM, and supply chain management, SCM, and customer relationship management, CRM. And finally, we'll talk about Salesforce program decisions. So this is the outline which is governing our chapter, chapter number two. So this is a brief and a quick introduction about what we are going to do. Now, let's begin the class by providing you with a figure. Well, this figure, it is going to provide us with the Salesforce decision sequence. Well, the word sequence, it means process, step by step. Well, generally, if you are going to look at this, we would like to give you an actual example. Any investor, any businesswoman or man, if he or she would like to invest their own money in a business or project, they are going to say, we need something called business strategy. We need something called marketing strategy. So both of these two strategies, they are taken by the top management. So the top management, they are classified to be the brainers or the brains who are going to say yes or no, we should go investing or we should not go investing. But this decision is going to be taken according to what? According to something simple, which is called needs assessment study. Therefore, if you are going to be a businesswoman, and imagine you are having about $10,000 or 15 or something like that, and you are about to take a decision to make a business in Gaza. Before we are going to say we should go with this business or that, we should make something called needs assessment. So this needs assessment study, through it, we are going to say if our business or if our factory is required or needed by the customers or not. So if the needs assessment said people do need this kind of business, then we are going to say we should invest. But if the needs assessment studies told us people do not need such service or such a product, then we cannot go on with this investing. For example, if you would like or if you are thinking to establish a factory which is going to manufacture shoes, before we are going to take this step, we should make a needs assessment study through which we would like to know if Gaza Strip is processing and how many factories which are producing pair of shoes or shoes. If the needs assessment study told us that currently Gaza Strip is in a bad need for such factory, simply because shoes, all of them, with 100%, they are imported from outside, then do we think about a good, positive idea for establishing a factory? Yes. Because all the products are imported from outside. And we do not have a genuine factory or local factory which is producing the similar product. So this is going to be a beginning of the first step. Now, so the business strategy is approved by whom? By the top managers. According to results of the needs assessment study. Generally, if there is a green bus or green line for obtaining something called business strategy, then we should talk about marketing strategy. But why we are going to need a marketing strategy? Simply because this is the channel or the window or the door or the bridge through which we are going to market for our own product. This is the channel through which we are going to market for our own product. Therefore, business strategy along with the market strategy, both of them, they are classified to be the first two steps in the sequence of the Salesforce decision. In the sequence of the Salesforce decision. Type, is this a step followed by other steps? Of course, it is followed by other steps. Therefore, if you are going to talk about the level two, we are talking about strategy implementation decisions. Well, let's focus on the word implementation. What we bought through strategies in the first level, it must be accompanied by actions and procedures on the ground so that we could execute it. How we are going to execute and implement them is through the strategy implementation decision. So this level, it includes four approaches, four methods. Some of these methods included go-to-market strategy, in which we are going to adopt something called field work. We will talk about this later on in a very detailed way. Also, it includes customer relationship management. In addition, it includes supply chain management. Or finally, product development management. So these are the three or the four major approaches through which we will express our effort or goal of implementation. But is this enough? No. Still, we are talking about level number three. Now, let's review what we talked about so far. So in the first level, we are talking about decisions taken by the top management regarding adopting business as well as marketing strategy. Level two, we are talking about implementation process. Number three, we are talking about organizing ourselves as a Salesforce team. Therefore, level number three, Salesforce program decision, in which we will talk about account relationship strategy. Account relationship strategy. So we are talking about strategy. We are talking about relationship with who? Customer. Type, each relationship has two partners. The first partner here is the customer. Type, what about the second partner?
Salesperson.
Exactly. Well, they are us. So we are talking about ourselves as sales staff members. So here, we need to structure ourselves. We need to organize ourselves. Who is going to be the head? Who is going to be the supervisor? Who is going to be the field salesperson? Who is going to work under the customer service department? And so on and so on. So we need to organize ourselves under organizational structure. Also, we need to identify what are the major activities which we are going to do. and how these activities should be divided among the members of the team. Also, we should talk about our competencies and skills. If Haneen is possessing specific skills or competency and Wala doesn't, this means Wala should be trained so that she can acquire the same competency or skill. Also, we should talk about the leadership. Who are our leaders and how they are going to aspire us or inspire us, and how they are going to motivate us, and how they are going to be sure that everything is controllable. So all these things are going to be answered within this level, level number 3, which is focusing on Salesforce program decision. In other words, we are talking about organizing ourselves as a sales team or as a salesperson. So these briefly are the major levels or the sequence of the major levels of any Salesforce decision. Any question, any comments about this? Any question, any comments? Okay, move. This is something very important. Not because we are going to focus it on the midterm exam, but also because this question or these questions, you might be exposed to them, especially if you are going to make a working interview later on, inshallah, after your graduation. In other words, many of the interviewers, they are going to ask you, what are the major differences between efficiency and effectiveness? Well, listen here. The whole business courses, they are revolving around these two words, efficiency and effectiveness. So let's explain them in a very detailed way. The word efficiency, it means getting the most output from the least amount of the inputs. Somebody might say this definition or interpretation isn't clear enough. That's fine. We can add others or other information. Also, it means doing things right. Somebody might say also it isn't clear. We might say it is concerned with the means, tools, methods, approaches. Now, listen here. If you are going to look at the word right, right from a grammatical point of view, it is adverb. Adverb. Well, adverb, as we studied, it describes what? Actions or deeds. Now, all the businesses, they are going to have actions and deeds, which are controlled by three major things. Number one, time, effort, excellent, and cost. So this is our framework of the business. This is our framework of the business. So all businesses, they will do their own best to be sure that they will work and produce with the least amount of time, the least amount of effort, and the least amount of cost. In other words, we should express this relationship by a minus relationship, which means the least amount. The least amount. Okay? Yes. Now, if we are able to do this, this means our title or our sales organization is classified to be efficient. However, on the other hand, if we are not able to control our effort and cost and time, this means our ability to be an efficient company is limited. And we might be classified to be inefficient company. Inefficient company. Is this clear? Now, let's go to the second hand of this definition, which is effectiveness. Effectiveness, it is revolving around one word, which are organizational goals or ends. Therefore, completing activities so that organizational goals are attained or doing the right things, or it means concerned with the ends, which means goals. Now, let's come here. If you are going to look at the word right here, it is adjective. As you know, the adjectives, they are describing nouns rather than actions. Rather than actions. Therefore, whenever we are going to say right things, things means ends or goals. So this means what? It means the following. The more the management of the organization will be able to achieve the goals, the more they are going to be named to be what? Effective. Or the vice versa is correct. In other words, if you are not able to achieve your goals, this means your company is not effective enough. Is not effective enough. Now, somebody is going to wonder, are we talking about interrelated relationship between the efficiency and the effectiveness? The answer is yes. Therefore, effectiveness and efficiency, both of them, they are interrelated and sometimes overlapped. And what's the meaning of overlapped? Okay, in other words, sometimes one coin or one face of this coin might be an expression for the second face. In other words, sometimes efficiency, we might be confused and we might say it means the same meaning of effectiveness. And the same thing with effectiveness regarding efficiency. Let's give example. Now listen. Imagine we took a decision to establish our shoes factory. We imagine we are talking or calculating about this scenario. The scenario is saying to produce a pair of shoes, this process is requiring about 1 hour. To produce what? A pair of shoes. 1 hour. The price of 1 hour is about, for example, let's say $2. $2. Imagine regarding the actual work, we are talking about a scenario where each pair of shoes is requiring us 2 hours to be produced. So the cost for producing a pair of shoes will be 4 hours. Or $4, sorry, $4. Now, this $4, is it related to the cost? Yes. Is it related to the time? Of course. Is it related to the effort?
Yes.
Of course. Let's talk about another scenario. Our management is smart. They innovated a new approach of producing by which the time is going to be what?
Less.
1 hour only, not 2 hours. So in this case, we are going to talk about what? 2 hours. Well, this is going to be less. The effort and the cost and the time. So which scenario is better? This one or that one? This one. But is it related to profit? Of course. The less cost we are going to invest and the less effort we are going to invest, this means the more profit we will gain.
Yes.
And the vice versa is correct. The profit itself is what? Well, the goal is what? Exactly. Because of this, we are saying efficiency and effectiveness, both of them, they are interrelated or interconnected or overlapped. The more profit, this means we are talking about the goals. But the goals is related for, this things is related to efficiency. Because of this, we cannot separate, we cannot make a clear cut between the two definitions. Both of them, they are interrelated. Any question, any comments about this? Any question, any comments? Clear? Fair enough. Go on. Let's talk now about a new topic, which is called business strategy. Well, under the business strategy, we will define something called this strategy. It is founded on what? It means what? Now listen, the business strategy, it involves defining and articulating an overall business mission in addition with its own goals and finally a mechanism for achieving these goals. So if we would like to break or divide this definition into components, we are going to see the following. Number one, we are talking about missions. Number two, we are talking about goals. Number three, we are talking about mechanism of achieving. This is the definition of business strategy. So business strategy all the time, remember, it is a document through which we will identify mission, then goals, and then a mechanism for achieving these goals. That's it. This is what?
Business
strategy. So once again, business strategy, we are referring to a document through which we are going to identify our own mission, the mission of our business, I mean, وسكند the goals of this business وثيرد a mechanism for achieving or implementing these goals. So by this we are saying we are talking about business strategy. Is it simple? It's very simple. Okay? طب let's talk about its own sister, which is marketing strategy. In marketing strategy, remember, we are referring to a set of integrated decisions and actions. When we are saying integrated, means all the decisions and the steps, they are influencing one another. Or they are founded on one another. A business undertakes, a business takes. Why? To achieve its marketing objectives. To achieve its marketing objectives. So marketing strategy decisions are related to market segmentation and target marketing as well as the development of positioning strategy. So let's divide this definition once again. So marketing strategy, it is a strategy or a decisions to answer three things. Number one, market segmentation. Number two, our target customers. Number three, our positioning strategy. So if we are able to identify this thing, the market segmentation, our target group, and our positioning strategy, this means we are talking about marketing strategy. Now, let's take them one by one, or by giving you an actual example. Now, remember, if you are having about 5 or 10,000 US dollars, and you would like to invest them in any business around the university or the university compound. With this university compound, it includes Al-Azhar, IUG, as well as Al-Aqsa University. You are saying, I would like to have a study, I would like to conduct a study through which I will be sure that my decision is correct as much as I can. If you would like to have a correct decision, this means you have to segment your market. How we are going to segment our market? We are going to look at this area. And we are going to look at the people or population who are repeatedly coming almost every day to this area. You are going to look at the population and you are going to feel that the majority of them, they are students. The majority of them, they are students. Now, those students, they might be male and they might be female. But let's talk about their own needs. If you are going to look at their own needs, you are going to find they will need textbooks. They will need stationery. What's the meaning of stationery? Exactly. They will need computer services. They will need cheap meals. They will need cheap drinks and similar needs in this way. Somebody is going to wonder, "Tab, why you are adding the word or the adjective cheap?" Because all of us are students and our financial capacity is very limited. It's very humble. It's very limited and very humble. Now, so the market segmentation is the following. We look at the population. And we found that the students, they are considered to be the biggest group. So this is what? This is a group. Are we talking about a characteristic through which we can identify this group? Yes. What is the characteristic? Students. All the members within this group, they are students. Now, listen. So, by saying a group, we are talking about what? Target group or target customers. So by this way, we are coming to the second stage of the marketing strategy. Now let's focus on now. Well, let's talk about business strategy and how it is interrelated with the marketing strategy. So if you are having this amount of money, the 10,000 US dollar or the 7 or whatever, this means we are going to ask ourselves this question. What is the best business which we should go and invest in an area around these universities. For example, do you think is it a good decision to invest a car store around this area?
No.
Why?
Because the
student. Why?
Because the student don't need this type of project.
Yes, and they cannot afford the prices of this product. طب is it a good decision to open full and falafel decision or shop?
Yeah.
Yes. طب is it good to adopt or to open a shop through which we are going to provide, for example, kebab and shawarma or kofta for the students?
Maybe.
Not good enough. طب why? Because the prices of meat in our country is expensive.
Yes.
Therefore, we might not be sure if all the people or if all the students are or can afford the price of these meals. So what is the best decision out of the previous three examples? Exactly. Because the meals are economic and they are cheap, and at the same time they are classified to be a public dish. Public dish. Public favorite dish. So this is the best strategy. But how did we take a decision? Because of the market segmentation and identifying our target group. Okay? Is this the end of the story? No. This isn't the end of the story. Now let's come to what?
Positioning strategy.
And what is the meaning of positioning strategy? We will talk about this later on, but let's talk about it now. Positioning strategy, it is equivalent to one word, which is, read this. Perception. From the verb perceive. What's the meaning of perceive? Exactly. أو يتلقى. Now look at here. The perception of the customers to the product can be influenced through various factors. Through various factors. Some of these factors might be related to price. Some of these factors might be related to quality. Some of these factors might be related to brand name. Some of these factors might be related to the feeling of nationality. Some of these factors might be related to the color, packaging, etc., etc., etc. So all these factors, they are factors which helps you or help you to perceive this product. And after I'm going to perceive this product, I'm going to compare it along with the competitive products. Let's give example. Well, listen here. Let's talk about two competitive products.
Nokia,
I would like to simplify it. This is the item of perception. Oh, this is Coca-Cola. Oh, this is Mecca Coca-Cola. Oh, both of them, they are competitive or competitor products. Now, the item we are going to compare, look at here, price. We are going to compare between the two through quality, experience, nationality. What else? Nationality.
Brand.
Okay, we talk a brand, packaging, etc. So these are the factors of our what perception to the product. Now let's begin. If we would like to compare between the Coca-Cola and Mecca-Cola regarding the price, who's the winner? Mecca, because it is cheaper, ولا. طب if we would like to compare between the two products regarding the quality, experience, nationality, it might be this, because this is American product.
Yes.
Also brand, packaging. So under this current situation, who is the winner? This product. Somebody is going to say, طب when the company or the marketing strategy, they are going to realize that the winner between these two competitive products are founded on these factors. Is it helpful for them to compete? Of course. Because these are the forces through which we are going to attract the customer to buy the product. Okay? Well, this is the meaning of what? Positioning strategy. So positioning strategy means perception. How customers perceive or look at the product and compare it with the competitive products regarding various items. So if the sales company or organization will be able to identify these factors, this means they should work hard on this factor so that they could satisfy the customers. Or by this way, they can ensure a raise of their own sales. Any question, any comments? Any question, any comments about this? So let's summarize. So marketing strategy, once again, they are referring to decisions that are related to market segmentation, identifying our market or target group, as well as positioning strategy. All of them, they should be answered, and they are considered to be the major elements for having a marketing strategy. This is important, or it might be a question in the midterm exam. Now, let's talk about segmentation and target market. I think we gave you many examples about them. So market segmentation, it involves aggregating customers into groups. Each group has one or more common characteristics. Well, these characteristics might be founded on age, gender, culture, level of income, etc., 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 and even residency. What's the meaning of residency? The location where we are living. All these are common characteristics. Okay? Number two, this group has a similar needs. Like the example through which we talked about the students. We said they need cheap meals, cheap drinks, laptops, computers, computer services, as well as textbooks and stationery. So all the needs are similar. Also the third, they will respond similarly to marketing programs. In other words, a man is a student. Whenever she is going to spend 7 or 8 hours in the university, for sure she is going to be angry. Yes. The same thing with Hanin. The same thing with Wala. So hunger is a common need. A textbook is a common need. But why? All of us are students. So this is our characteristic within the membership of this group. Okay? Clear? Any question, any comments about this? Okay. So let's sum up. Target marketing refers to the selection and prioritizing of segments to the company that will market. Therefore, the target marketing refers to the selection and prioritizing of the segments to the company will market. In other words, target marketing refers to the target group of our customers which we should hunt down as a company. As a company. Any question, any comments about this? Any question? Any comments? Move. Let's conclude by positioning a strategy. Well, as we said before, whenever we are going to talk about positioning strategy, we have to remember one word, which is perception. In other words, positioning strategy is developed and implemented based on product, price, distribution, and the promotion decisions. A promotion decision includes what? The packaging, will color, and etc., and other components. Okay, so positioning occurs in the mind of the consumer. It is a psychological conceptual process and refers to how the consumer perceives, realizes, looks at the product, brand, company, vis-a-vis a competitors. Competitors what? Competitive products. Clear? Any question, any comments? So remember and focus on this word, perception. How we are perceiving or realizing or looking at the product and its own competitive ones. Regarding what? These items. Are these items important? Of course. Why? Simply because if the sales organization are able to identify what are the strongest items which are attracting the customers, this means they will work on enhancing them. If they succeeded on enhancing them, they will ensure attracting a maximum number of customers. Exactly. Okay? Any question or comments? Move on. Before move on, listen. What happened in the last 2 days? American embassy in Benghazi was attacked and banned. And the American ambassador got killed, along with the other 3 guys. The same thing with the American embassy in the capital of Yemen. Also, the American embassy in Cairo was attacked. And the American flag was burned down. So all these actions, they are what? They are actions which are happening in markets, big markets. So do you think the companies or the producers or even the distributors, they should take these accounts or events into account?
Yes.
Of course. Therefore, if I am an owner of supermarket, within the 2 days or within the couple of weeks ahead, or which are going to come, I am going to all the time import Mecca Coca-Cola and try to ignore Coca-Cola at this stage. But why? Because the item of perception now, which is considered to be the winning, is nationality. Exactly. Exactly. So when the consumer is going to knock down on the supermarket or my shop and he is going to drink or have a soft drink, for sure the feeling of nationality is going to be a winning at this stage. Okay? Now move on, finally. So the fundamental questions now that customers ask about brands are, number one, who are you? Brand identity. Are you American product or are you Arab Muslim product? The same thing, what are you? Brand meaning. What do I think or feel about you? Brand responses. What kind and how much association would I like to have with you? Brand relationship. Now, all these questions, they are what? Psychological questions. And who is going to answer them? The customer. Where? In his own mind and feelings. You as a sales organization, what you should do? We should anticipate and study carefully what are the major points through which this customer will focus on while he is perceiving our product in comparison with the competitive products. Any question, any comments so far? It's easy, it's clear. Now listen, as we said in the final, sorry, in the midterm exam, I might ask you several questions. Define, for example, positioning strategy. Explain marketing strategy or business strategy. Compare and contrast between business and marketing strategies. Compare and contrast between efficiency and effectiveness. All these questions are very important. Or they might be in the middle. Any question or comments? Okay, before I'm going to conclude, who didn't pick up a sales organization from Gaza regarding the research group? Till now you didn't pick up one? You have? Okay, what's it?
Flashpoint.
Okay, go on. Hamad Group, its core business is what? Food? Wood. Furniture and furniture? Okay, what else? You do not know now? Who are the members of your group? You must choose. Because work alone isn't allowed. The group must consist of 2 members, or 3, or 4. 5 isn't allowed. 1 isn't allowed. Okay? Are you following me? What's your name? Business company?
Cosmo.
Okay.
Sales product for skincare and hair care.
Okay, good. What else? Dir al-Balah. Okay. Next, good. Who didn't pick up a business so far? Who didn't pick up a business? You must finalize picking up a business. Do you have a group?
No, this is the first.
Do you have a group? Who didn't have a group? You? Raise your hand, please. You and you and you. 4? Okay, look at here. You can join one group if you would like. Look at here. You can form a group. Okay? Now listen. Somebody is going to ask what we are going to do in our research paper. Next class, I'm going to explain to you in a very detailed way what you should do. Okay? Thank you very much. See you next time.